getting some type of a signal right now. I'm not exactly sure what that signal was. So get in your seats and get ready for an awesome game of Quidditch.
Both Gryffindor and Ravenclaw are now taking position. The referees are getting them in order, and both teams are now about ready to begin.
Don't forget to head over to the snack shack, the wizard shack, full of many treats and pizzas of the wizard worlds. Hogsmeade, I'm being told. Hogsmeade.
I believe they have non-alcoholic butterbeer there, which is always amazing. To thank all the fans for coming out here today to support the Quidditch teams of Harriton. Right now, it looks like we're about ready to start. The referees are lining up, and the teams are getting ready to begin.
But before we begin, might be interesting to tell you about the history of Muggle Quidditch. Here's Ben Feldman to tell us more about the history. Real Quidditch. Wait, what?
So, we'll explain now for those of you Muggles who don't know about Quidditch from Harry Potter. We'll have one keeper who will be defending the net from the ball. Now, we remember that if the chasers who carry the quaffle, which is the ball that we will be using for most of the game, if they can get it through the hoop, that will count as points for their team. Right now, it will be Ravenclaw against Gryffindor in the first game. Now, there's also the beaters, who will also try to defend the rings by, in this game, they'll be throwing balls at the chasers.
And it appears that Gryffindor and Ravenclaw they're getting ready. This is going to be exciting.
And one more element, some would say the most important element of this game, would be the Seeker, who always tries to catch the golden snitch. And Harry Potter that was Harry Potter's job in the books.
So cute. Oh my god, so cute.
Well, here's some history about Muggle Quidditch. It was originally created in 2005 at Middlebury College in Middlebury, Vermont, by Xander Manchel and Alex Benepi. So, yeah, this has been a thing actually for some time now, this Muggle Quidditch. This is the 10-year anniversary of Muggle Quidditch.
And for fans who are just joining us now, we'd like you to take your seats as the game is about to begin.
Yes, yes it is.
No, today's Thursday. And how would you know that?
I'll explain to you what you're seeing at the field. On both sides of the field, there are three circular goals that were created by Mr. Lehman a few years back. They are traditionally on top of PVC pipes. The ball that we use in this game is a quaffle, as the game seems to be, as the game is now about to begin. Oh, wait, let's see.
With
Ravenclaw moving.
I'm obsessed.
Ravenclaw moving.
I'm obsessed. No, don't start without me.
Let's see what this. And the ball is up. Ravenclaw, who's going to take it first? Rivendor takes it. Rivendor takes it down the field. Takes it past the 30.
It's a pass. And the Ravenclaw keeper gets the ball, passes it down. And that'll be another pass over. Ravenclaw now with the ball driving down the field. Gryffindor in the attempting to block him. And that'll be 30 down. But Ravenclaw is hit with a bludger. Gryffindor now with the ball, leading down the field. Gryffindor with the ball, and the bludger. The bludger misses. And now, in striking distance, no goal. Official North Carpel.
Yes, this is true. So, today, as you can see, we have officials of Noah Carbell, Kobe Levitt as in the red thingy-mabobbin with the hat with stars. We also have Jake Diamond Ravitch on the other side. He's now waving to us.
And now Ravenclaw with the ball, with the quaffle, driving down the field. And it's a pass. Ravenclaw now within striking distance. And into the bludger. So, Gryffindor takes over. Gryffindor now driving down the field. And the pass is intercepted by Ravenclaw. Now Gryffindor has the ball, and the beater passes it back. It's now, and the officials are now ruling that it is Gryffindor ball. Ravenclaw misses with the bludger. Gryffindor, now in striking distance. Gryffindor has the ball. And it's a pass. Now again, striking distance for Gryffindor. Gryffindor recovering, dodging the bludger, and a pass out towards center. So, hit with the bludger is Gryffindor, so now Ravenclaw has the ball.
So how's your day been, Ben?
My day has been fantastic, Ricky. How has your day been?
It's been a very magical day, I must say. Yes, of course, magical. We, of course, are from the Harriton TV station. Magical day for us is we found out that it was not China who was the source of all of our problems why we did not go live. In fact, it was someone at the tech department here in Lower Merion School District.
So now, after that nice shot, Gryffindor will now get the ball back to the playing field. It's been very active on the Ravenclaw keeper side. Gryffindor now again caught with the puck. In striking distance, and no goals as official, no cartel. Ravenclaw has the ball, taking it back to the field.
Not exactly sure what Kobe was doing over there. Looks like he had a phone out. Phones are not permitted in the sport of Quidditch. They are far too advanced for our measly wizard minds. And now, Gryffindor returns with the ball. Dodges a bludger, and
It's a goal, says official Noah Carpo. So that'll give Griffin the score. And now, official Jake Diamond Ravitch gives the ball back to.
As you can see, Gryffindor is home. What really is home? Gryffindor is home today.
Everyone is home today at Harriton. And now the ball is ruled dead by the officials. So it looks like it will be Gryffindor ball at midfield. Gryffindor now going downfield, passing it, and it is going to be blocked by the Ravenclaw keeper. Ravenclaw now driving, hit with a bludger, and that'll be back to Gryffindor ball. Gryffindor waffle, if you will. And it'll be Gryffindor ball, Gryffindor quaffle again. Almost to the bludger. And now he is. It'll be Ravenclaw ball. Driving down, but it will be Gryffindor again. These beaters have been very effective today. There have been many turnovers. Officials are giving Gryffindor the quaffle over at midfield. Going down the field now in striking distance, dodges a bludger, and out towards center, intercepted by Ravenclaw. So, and that could be a penalty of sorts. Ravenclaw now with the quaffle, driving down. And now in striking distance.
No, it was not. Did not go in. Oh, yes, it did go in. It did? Okay.
Yes.
So, what do you call a wizard's favorite Beach Boys song?
I don't know.
Help me, Wanda!
Oh, look at this, and they're saying it did not go in. The official's call has been reversed. Gryffindor hit with a bludger, and that'll be a turnover. Ravenclaw quaffle. Ravenclaw now driving down the field. Ravenclaw drops the ball, and hit the bludger. It's Ravenclaw. And that'll be a pass up towards midfield. Got me by Ravenclaw.
Does a wizard get as a room service? I see that one. What does a wizard get at a hotel?
I don't know, Ricky.
What? Room service!
Well, that was quite the pun. And now we return. It's Gryffindor's quaffle driving down the field. Through the bludger, but he got the pass off in time. So, it'll be Ravenclaw ball. Ravenclaw quaffle. Ravenclaw now driving down the field. And it'll be a pass out towards center. And this could be a goal. And that's a goal. The officials mark it good.
So, and it's taking a team picture down there.
So now the score will be tied. One apiece, 10 points for both teams.
like I should mention that I really haven't seen that many Harry Potter movies, but I do have a lot of jokes about them because of the internet.
Yes, I have seen the Harry Potter movies, but that's neither here nor there. So now we'll return to the game as Gryffindor now with a pass way over the goals, and it'll be Gryffindor ball. Gryffindor receives ball. Avoids the bludger.
Oh, and that looks like it's the Golden Snitch all along the track. The Golden Snitch is running down the track. The people are running out of both the Ravenclaw and Gryffindor. And now they're running faster. The Snitch is getting away from our view, so we're going to return back to the game. We'll keep an eye on the Snitch. The Snitch has gotten away for now as people now return their action to the game.
Ravenclaw has the ball driving down. Fudge's already, whereas the
Snitch is... Someone's getting close to the Snitch.
Two Gryffindors are cornering the Snitch. And almost had him.
Gryffindor... The Snitch is running away. Now Slytherin is... And no, Slytherin's not there. Why am I saying Slytherin? Has the Snitch been gotten? Ravenclaw has gotten the Snitch. So Ravenclaw came out of nowhere and got the Snitch. Hey everyone, we have breaking news. There are actually two Snitches. Two. See, as you can see over there, Micah is running on the right side. He's being followed by Gryffindor. Gryffindor is running get the Snitch. He doesn't really look like a Snitch. Can Micah run away? Oh, wait, Gryffindor scored.
So, that'll be an extra point for Gryffindor. And now...
Yeah, so we'll keep an eye out for the Snitches tonight. They'll be coming out of anywhere, here and there and everywhere.
So now Ravenclaw hit with the bludger, now turns the ball over to Gryffindor and the Golden Snitch running down the field. Two Gryffindors are rapidly gaining on the Golden Snitch. We'll keep you posted on that. Gryffindor now with the ball, driving down the field. Gryffindor with the pass, it's over the goal, so that'll be no goal. Ball's official, no carpet. And the Golden Snitch is now running. We have a Ravenclaw, now leading, cornering.
Oh, whoa. It's close now. Ravenclaw almost has the Snitch. The Snitch has been gotten by the Ravenclaw. Let's see, gonna get it. The Snitch has been gotten by Ravenclaw. 30 points or something like that. 30 points for 20 points for Ravenclaw. The Snitch is down. He doesn't actually look good. We have to have someone check on the Snitch. Oh, the Snitch is getting back up. The Snitch is slowly walking. He looks a little hurt. Or not. I don't know. He's slowly walking over in defeat as he is so sad right now.
Now to get back to the actual game. Ravenclaw now very close to striking distance. Ravenclaw with the ball about 25 yards back. And Ravenclaw now in striking distance, a pass toward center. And it's batted away by the Gryffindors. Gryffindor, the keeper, now passing it down. And it looks like it's going to be intercepted by Ravenclaw. And is this a Snitch over on the side of the field? Do you mind? And the hunt for the Golden Snitch is on. Two Ravenclaw is now cornering in. The Golden Snitch is now running behind the goals. And another Golden Snitch on the track closest to the fans. Gryffindor now has the Golden Snitch. So that'll be an extra 20 points for Gryffindor.
Gryffindor now running down the field. Gryffindor passes again. Knocked away, it hits Noah Carpel.
And the other
interference by the officials there.
but they won't rule it inefficient. They won't rule that as interference because that would be ridiculous.
But again, is there really anything?
Wait a second. The Golden Snitch is taken by Ravenclaw.
A lot of Golden Snitches in this game, I must say.
Yes, that is quite interesting. You've already seen four Golden Snitches. So, with now a lead, 70-40, Ravenclaw with the ball. Ravenclaw now getting ready to drive down the field.
Akron has slowed a little bit right now. But a decision has been made. Round.
And now, Ravenclaw, the keeper.
Please disregard the scoreboard right now.
And now, Gryffindor with the quaffle. Driving down, but it's intercepted by Ravenclaw. Ravenclaw with the quaffle.
Ravenclaw quickly running it down the field. Bringing it down to the 40, passing it over to the 30.
It's good. The officials mark it as a score, so that'll be an extra 10 points for the Ravenclaws. So now, Gryffindor. And both teams are now regrouping. We have 4 minutes and 15 seconds left. Gryffindor now going down the field. And hit with a bludger is Gryffindor, so it'll be
Ravenclaw.
And it seems to be Gryffindor seems to have a lead, but Ravenclaw, right on the snitch's tail.
Ravenclaw running, where's Gryffindor? I can't even see it. I need to get my binoculars.
Who comes over with the snitch? And Gryffindor seems to be celebrating, so it appears that Gryffindor has the snitch. Gryffindor now driving. And that'll be a takeaway by the Ravenclaws. Ravenclaws now driving, coming very close to scoring distance, and it's a pass out towards center. Who the bludger is Ravenclaw, so that'll be now Gryffindor ball. And Gryffindor now, again with the quaffle, high pass, and that'll be down to Ravenclaw ball. It appears.
Oh, wait, another snitch is running down the field. A player from Gryffindor is quickly coaching in. Now one from Ravenclaw is coaching. Now wait, Ravenclaw is right there. Snitch is behind the net. The Ravenclaw cannot, we'll watch this standoff and we'll tell you as it continues.
Now, two Ravenclaws and two Gryffindors now trying to corner the snitch behind the net. Meanwhile, it will be Ravenclaw ball in striking distance. Ravenclaws. Now, the ball is not dead. And the snitch is running along the sidelines. And Ravenclaws quickly approaching. The snitches just barely escapes. The snitch now going off towards the Gryffindor sidelines. The snitch nearly manages to escape, and Gryffindor nearly comes up with it. And Gryffindor comes up with a golden snitch. So that'll be an extra point, an extra 20 points for Gryffindor. That is a game changer. Now, we'd like to remind you all that there is 26 seconds left. Gryffindor now driving. Gryffindor with a quaffle. And there is 10 seconds left. Ravenclaw with a quaffle. One. And that's time. Gryffindor comes away with a victory.
A great comeback for Gryffindor as they come back to win this game. According to the scoreboard of 90-80, we can verify that thing.
Yes. And that win for Gryffindor will be attributed to the catching of the golden snitch with 26 seconds left. That's a game changer. So now, Gryffindor coming away with the win as they get ready to move on. An unfortunate loss for Ravenclaw, who is leading for most of the game.
We'll take a quick break, and you'll hear us in a second. So a lot of things going on the field right now. Hopefully you guys can still hear us as we just switch microphones. Please someone tell us if you can hear us. Anyone?
Yeah.
Good. Thank you. We needed that. So let's see what goes on right now.
So now, with Gryffindor and Ravenclaw having played their first game, we'll now see a match of Slytherin against Hufflepuff. This will be great game, and the winner will play Gryffindor.
I'm very excited for this game. This game means a lot to both teams. They've been practicing for days now.
So very exciting time for everyone.
So.
Who wants to hear more jokes?
Anyone?
I'm sure we all want to hear more jokes.
Can you hear more jokes? Can you even hear me?
Can hear us.
I think they can hear you, but not me. Someone hear me?
Okay. We'll go with it. So there's a lot of exciting things happening right now here at Harriton. There is a, currently I believe the girls' soccer team. Apparently very soon going to be spring for it. Very exciting that they won 1-0 earlier this week. And now here's a joke that you may or may not like.
I suspect that everybody will dislike this joke, but continue.
How many muggles does it take to screw in a light bulb?
How many?
One. It is the only thing they are good for.
What?
I don't know. I'm listening to this on the website.
Alright then.
This website is not the best. I am going to stop reading from it, as I no longer like the website. What do you think of the website? Hello? So, a lot of things being switched up right now. A lot of things. So we're in waiting. How long will
here's one of the few good jokes on this website, Ricky.
Oh, cool.
Why does Voldemort only use Twitter and not Facebook?
Because doesn't have a face?
No, not quite. Because he only has followers, not friends.
Ah. Hear this live interview. Can I get a what? Here we go. There we go. Let's talk to Noah here. Noah, what do you think of the last game? You win? You lose? I'm not sure.
They won.
You think there was too many snitches? Okay, thank you, Noah, as we now get back to the action here at Harriton School. Again, we are here at Harriton Stadium, moon in the sky as Harriton Baby
Good one. Hey, speaking of good ones, Ricky, here's a knock-knock joke. Knock-knock.
Who's there?
You know.
You know who?
Say it that way.
You know who?
Well, if you know who that is at my door, I'm not opening it.
Okay.
Another terrible joke, brought to you by...
jokesforus.com / Harry Potter jokes.
Yes. Well, that's enough jokes for the immediate future.
Don't forget to head over to the Snack Shack. Place for the snacks are not black. They're good snacks. So go there, please.
So now we are getting ready. We're now getting ready to start game two between Hufflepuff and Slytherin. Slytherin now breaking from the huddle and taking their spots.
Don't you use Hufflepuff?
Hufflepuff is still in the huddle. And now they break. So the game will be starting any minute.
Was my sister. I did not permit her to say anything. She kind of just stole the mic.
So now we get ready to begin the game. Rick is now ready to start the game.
In yellow is Hufflepuff.
lined up at their respective sides, 5 yards away from our referees. And we get ready to begin.
Anyone else think that? Hufflepuff.
Sounds like a different color.
Yes.
I'm not sure why that is.
And the ball is way up on the Hufflepuff side. Hufflepuff takes the ball.
Hufflepuff going down the field. One back to 40. This guy is fast.
Hufflepuff now continuing to drive, trying to avoid the bludgers. And Hufflepuff now hit the bludger. Turns the ball over to Slytherin. Slytherin now with the ball. Gruffle, Slytherin, getting ready to pass the ball. Pass the puff, and Gruffle is now over on the Hufflepuff side.
All this time,
that was terrible.
Was it?
Yes.
It's kind of true.
Well, I don't want to waffle at this time.
You want to waffle?
The Slytherin keeper gets the ball, passes it down, and Slytherin now driving. But the beater is ready to... And the referees call that it will be. Yes, it will be. Hufflepuff Quaffle. So, Hufflepuff now. Quaffle. And it's down to the Hufflepuff keeper. Hufflepuff now driving down the field. And hit with the bludger is Hufflepuff, so that'll be a turnover. Slytherin now with the flopper. And driving down. That will be.
Oh wait, let's see Slytherin. Slytherin has it passed the next level.
And that'll be.
Drop the mob and have the mob as it falls.
So it's now Hufflepuff. Whoa, with a long pass down the field, and...
As a Desi football game, long passes.
And that'll be now, Slytherin. With the bubble driving all the way down along the sidelines.
Let's get some fans cheering. Let's cheer for the teams, everyone. Cheer.
Wait, two...
Yes. Let's get a cheer for Hufflepuff. Let's get a cheer for Hufflepuff.
And for Slytherin.
A cheer for Slytherin.
All right, well.
Anyone? Nope, it seems that no one wants to cheer.
And Hufflepuff now with Quaffle. Within striking distance, passes that out towards center, and... Oh, drives away from the bludger, and... Just barely misses. But look at this. That'll be a goal. Yes, a goal. For Hufflepuff in yellow.
I've been told we should talk more.
Hoopla! Well, alright.
So, can I get a hoopla? Hoopla!
Oh.
Okay. So, yeah, here it is. Not too cold in the night, you guys do. I don't think it's that cold. But let's, you know what, I'm just gonna go into more of a reporter voice, maybe a little more interested. Okay, so now, as the Slytherin takes it down the field, goes over, takes it up, up, now takes the ball. Hufflepuff now moving back down the field, passing midfield right now, back to Golden Levitt. And now they go to the 40.
And it's a turnover, Slytherin.
Slytherin takes the ball, Slytherin moving down quickly.
Quaffle. Here with a bludger, and it'll now be Hufflepuff Quaffle. Hufflepuff now.
Hufflepuff is deciding what to do.
Looks like there is a quaffle. There is a quaffle for the quaffle, if you will.
Incomplete, as we would say in the football world and sport not yet introduced yet. Actually, it is. I'm not sure.
So now the yellow Hufflepuff now in striking distance, and...
just a minute. You know, my reading of how Muggle Quidditch today, it's very nice about things about Muggle Quidditch. There's so many...
That is a goal. Rules official Jake Diamond Rivage. So that'll be another goal for Hufflepuff.
So as I said, in all games, outfits must have both men and female members of teams on the field. So that is great for Quidditches of the Quidditch.
Well, I don't think that's the right terminology, but it's the right idea. So now, Slytherin trying to take the lead, driving down the pitch.
Slytherin, that's a good Slytherin now, as they are throwing it over. The throwing it over is good, and the throwing it over is bad. Slytherin gets it in the movement. And is it? He's no good.
And Hufflepuff now gets the ball.
Hufflepuff moving over, and Hufflepuff running down the field quickly. But then the Slytherin gets it. Hufflepuff goes back one person, goes back another, past the 30. And they are going to
within striking distance.
Hufflepuff passed it. And Hufflepuff, can the Hufflepuff make it go? And
it's blocked down.
It's knocked down, and Slytherin now has the ball. A quaffle. The quaffle is now moving quickly down the field. Past the 40. Past the 49. Past the 80. Past the... thrown over Slytherin. Oh! They knocked into each other, and the ball was pushed loose.
No, this is not football. This is Quidditch.
Again, I said, as I was saying, a fumble in football, and I have no clue what it's called here in the Quidditch. I was just saying it was pushed out.
They don't have that word in Quidditch. It's just you drop the ball. So now, Hufflepuff driving down the pitch. And Hufflepuff now within striking distance, avoiding the blunders. And let's see if he'll be able to
make it.
Let's see if he'll be able to get a shot.
They're just kind of holding here. Looks like a giant
That looks like a trick play. But the officials rule it is not good.
Not exactly sure why my sister's out there in the middle of the action. Hufflepuff. And see if you can hear me, I'll move off the field. It's not that safe there. So much magic going on. Everyone's doing a good job flying tonight.
Yes.
Flying high, flying low.
It's a lot easier to fly when you're not actually flying.
But are they not actually flying?
So now, Slytherin with the quaffle.
They're quaffling.
And the official school. That it is good. It was good. So that'll be another 10 points for Hufflepuff. As referees are.
Hufflepuff now up 0 to 20. Nope. 0 to 30. Oh. Again, Slytherin with nil.
Slytherin really needed to retake the lead.
Yes, Slytherin does need to take the lead, bro.
If I were Slytherin, I would be on the loose. I would be on the watch for the Golden Snitch.
I would definitely be. There is the Golden Snitch. Where the Golden Snitch enter the game?
Well, definitely at one point.
Or would the Golden Snitch just sit and be won? I don't know.
As many people wishing they were.
Yes.
And with that, we'd like to thank you all for coming out today and supporting Quidditch again.
Don't forget to head over to the Snack Shack, the home of all things good food and good coffee.
Or should we say Hogsmeade?
Hogsmeade, they got pizza for $2, got candies for other amounts of money, that other stuff. That,
so now it'll be,
yes?
The Snitch!
What? We have someone entering the booth. Let's get your thoughts.
Oh, and the Golden Snitch is loose.
The Golden Snitch is loose. The Golden Snitch is
loose. The Golden Snitch is
running on the field. Who gets it? Oh, and it looks like it's getting by Hufflepuff. Hufflepuff gets the Golden Snitch, and they get another 20 points.
Literally.
Okay, so that last game.
The referees are trying to announce that. Hufflepuff did not get the Golden Snitch.
Thank you.
What's going on down there? Is there a referee that's built off the gate?
Referees, do we have a problem with the scoreboard?
Well,
no, it looks like we're good.
Things are moving very, very slowly right now. Maybe some penalties? I don't know.
Oh, and look at this Slytherin now. With the
proper... So I'm now sitting in a heater. Nice. Slytherin, pass it over, but the yellow...
And it's back to Hufflepuff.
...taken out by Hufflepuff, and Hufflepuff is looping down the field as they move forward to the net.
Oh, it's now Slytherin in striking distance.
Slytherin.
As in, right at the goal.
Oh, wait.
There is some kind of...
There is some kind of... That was a definite penalty or something. There,
some kind of kerfuffle over the quaffle, if you will.
Yes, a kerfuffle.
That one there.
It's now Hufflepuff Quaffle now.
Leading downfield. Oh, but hit with a bludger first. Yeah, so it will now be Slytherin Quaffle. And we'd like to remind you that there are 9 minutes and 10 seconds left in regulation. So, Slytherin now with a pass. It's dropped, but Hufflepuff now with a quaffle. Hufflepuff.
We're being joined by the chair of the finance committee, Huntress Corn. No? Is that allowed to talk? Thank you for those thoughts, Huntress Corn.
So, a long pass down the field. Hufflepuff. With the quaffle, Hufflepuff now in striking distance. And it's good for Hufflepuff. That'll be another 10 points for yellow.
Ten points to Hufflepuff. I need this louder. As they tell me, I have to be louder. Do you agree? I would just speak louder.
No, you don't need to,
turn around if you hear me. So you don't hear me.
And now Slytherin. Hit with the bludger, so it will now be Hufflepuff Quaffle. Hufflepuff with the pass. Getting ready to defend.
And let's get excited, because the Golden Snitch is going this one. Very fast, Golden Snitch. Hufflepuff quickly on the tail of the Golden Snitch, while Golden Snitch is moving around the field. And now there's the two. The Golden Snitch jumps. Jump, they jump the thing, now they're running down the track.
Golden Snitch along the side.
And they are... Looks like they're caught by Hufflepuff.
No, they're not. You're turning these against them. That looks like it's Slytherin.
Oh, Slytherin. I can't actually tell. All the colors kind of blend in after a while.
Yes.
Hufflepuff now up 50. Slytherin 30.
So now catching the Golden Snitch worth 20 points could tie the game for Slytherin.
For those of you just coming in, guest is Hufflepuff, which is yellow, and home is green is Slytherin.
And for those of you who missed the first game, that was a Gryffindor victory, 90-80.
The Snapchat resident is Hogsmeade.
I have heard a lot about Hogsmeade.
Hunter, tell us about a thing you're selling over at Hogsmeade.
All I can say is Mario has selling the fish, a hot pizza, only $2. We make it in a kitchen and it's really delicious.
So get that.
There you have it, folks.
Yes, yes, yes. Good pizza, good pizza.
Good. And now a message from our sponsor.
It appears there was some issue with Slytherin catching. And look at this, another golden snitch on the field.
The golden snitch running quickly, Hufflepuff, close behind, but no, wait, Slytherin just misses! Wait, double down! But, and it's like, oh, wait, and Slytherin does eventually get the golden snitch.
Yes, that'll be 20 points to Slytherin.
It looks like something's wrong with the scoreboard right now.
Who got that?
Referees, do we have an issue with the scoreboard?
Please excuse, we're facing technical difficulties with the scoreboard. Oh, now we're back to the actual score.
Referees, is the scoreboard correct?
50, Hufflepuff 50 in a crazy twist of events here at the Harriton.
Willie, what is our problem?
Pennsylvania.
What's our problem here? Hufflepuff got the snitch, not Slytherin.
Hufflepuff has it. Hufflepuff moving quickly down the field.
Hufflepuff navigating a tough Slytherin crowd tonight here at the Harriton Stadium.
And it looks like that is no good. So now, Slytherin. Driving down, we have 2 minutes and 28 seconds left in regulation.
Oh, and the bludgeon of the Slytherin fire, let's call that good. It's good. Just to everyone know, the score is actually 70-50. No, it's not 70-50. Hufflepuff getting ready to throw. Slytherin right there. Hufflepuff takes it. and Hufflepuff have any time for Hufflepuff, a score for Hufflepuff, that will be another 10 points for Hufflepuff. Let's get some cheers going. Let's get a cheer for Hufflepuff. Let's get a cheer for Slytherin. Awful Slytherin. Awful. Nope. Okay. Hufflepuff. Up, here for some in-between entertainment is Hufflepuff's scoring.
We're waiting confirmation as to what the next game will be, but all I can say is here, the Harriton Stadium seems like there's some reaction to this game. Hufflepuff in a resounding 60. Sorry, 80. Ladies and gentlemen, in this brief intermission, I'd encourage you to head right down to our very own snack shack. Pizza now down to $2. And a little brief announcement from the pizza cook in the kitchen, Mario. Hello, this is Mario, and we are making a fish of pizza in the kitchen. Now it is only $2. Hello, Kristen. Yes, you can try to see me. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 time. Ose, can you see when the stars? I don't know if I figure out how to start stronger batter goals.
Gryffindor
instead, now getting hyped up and getting back to their starting positions.
I read the news.
Yes, that's Ricky Sayre for you. Reading the news. Gryffindor and Hufflepuff now lining up.
It's like really soft, but nobody can hear.
Alright, let's get these levels
and
up.
And our referee is Noah Cartel and Jake Dyer.
Can't turn levels?
Nope.
Ricky, can we do rap battles up here?
No.
I already turned it all the way.
Why is it all the way up?
Because they couldn't hear us.
It must not be all the way up.
It is.
Dude, during football games, you can hear them clearly. And people are actually there
to
watch.
It's my thing, you think? Okay, then I'm going to turn it down and we're going to bypass it. Just go with one mic. Everyone cool with that?
Yeah, okay. I like one mic better.
Turn the volume down.
Which mic?
You can use this one.
No, it's not. Oh, yeah, it is that one.
This is a live jump.
Guys, I think this is actually kind of pointless. Like, to be honest, nobody hears. I can barely even hear you right in front of here.
You're going to hear us now. We're going to boost the speed.
I can't believe. I don't even know how Cynthia hears you. Like, it's really quiet.
It was working earlier. Somebody did something.
So, we are still here at Harriton Stadium. Can we get a what? Can?
Hey, we're good.
Yeah.
Where is this? All right, now let's do our announcements all over again, all right? Let me see.
This is a different mic. We're not sure it's working. If you hear us, then please do another what.
They can't hear us through that mic, Hunter.
Which mic?
But they can hear us through that one, so we gotta
Yes, they can hear us through here. This is cool.
What happened? Is there
only one mic? And the game looks like it's about to start between Hufflepuff.
There's only one mic?
Hufflepuff and Gryffindor. And Gryffindor. Gryffindor now, starting off with a Quaffle. Gryffindor driving down the pitch. And Gryffindor avoiding the bludger.
Yo, is there only one mic?
And now hit with the bludger.
Ricky, is there only one mic?
Is Gryffindor, so that'll be a turnover. Hufflepuff now with a Quaffle. Hufflepuff driving down the pitch.
And yes, Hufflepuff is driving down the pitch. Hufflepuff. Yes, a good contribution. Hufflepuff! But he's intercepted. Well, intercepted, but it's Gryffindor. Taken now by Gryffindor, as Gryffindor now has the Quaffle. Gryffindor quickly running down the field. Pass down over to the cut.
Falling down a couple notches. Not you, not the thing.
No, here, Ricky.
No, your voice. You're like screaming into the mic.
Oh, okay. Ricky, can I have this?
Room. Oh, yeah, we need some color commentary, dude. Somebody spice things up here.
Yeah, come on. I think Dave is the man for that. Mickey, right, pass the dance for a little bit.
Pass down the pitch.
Say.
Gryffindor keeper now with the Quaffle. Gryffindor now a long pass down towards the middle of the pitch. Gryffindor with the Quaffle. And a long pass into striking distances. Gryffindor.
Ooh, that's
Gryffindor with the Quaffle and seems to be hit with a bludger.
Slow to get up.
It will be Hufflepuff.
Who's slow to get up?
Whoever that was, but they're up now.
Someone was slow to get up, but they are up now.
Now, Hufflepuff with the Quaffle. Hufflepuff slowly making its way back towards
making
towards
its way
the bench. And that'll be the Hufflepuff keeper with the Quaffle. Here's ready, and that'll be a pass down.
And it looks like Hufflepuff takes the
ball. Ooh.
The Quaffle.
That's got to be some kind of foul. He just knocked over his thing.
Let's see how the referee
like having fouls. Ow, what
What's
do
up?
They
no
do?
Fouls? Every man for himself?
Question to not be raised as to possibility of a foul here.
No, there will be... It looks like there will be no foul.
No foul called by... I guess didn't.
Where is the flag?
Do you guys want to move over to that, please?
For those of you just coming in or just tuning in to our announcements here, right now, this is the Harriton Quidditch 2015 finals.
Let's get a crowd psyched here.
I want to get...
I'm going to make it cool here. I'm going to spice things up here.
Wait, what?
No one here.
We're moving over to there.
Because there's too many things in here.
I'm feeling good here.
We are, we want, like, I don't know.
Are we live right now?
Yeah.
Rick, if you're filling things, this has to be used tomorrow night for football games.
Oh, don't, everything will be the same.
Yo, can I tell them J.K. Rowling's in the building?
We're being told now that J.K. Rowling is in the building.
I'm going to get sick because they start yelling again about that.
Sick
because they're like, J.K. Rowling is actually here.
Is J.K. Rowling really in the building? We do not know. So let's see what's going on.
He thinks everything you do seriously is
from
Olivia.
A kerfuffle going on down the field over there.
Whose wand is this?
Ben, any thoughts?
Seriously, check this out.
It's like a real wand.
You know, it's like the real deal. That's what Harry Potter is using.
All right,
I'm
out of
here. Good luck with the schoolwork.
Oh, you're leaving?
Okay, so I'll be popping back in.
Yes,
there's no place for me.
Good in this game. but offense are less, kind of like the Philadelphia Eagles.
Oh, look at that. It is no good.
Still no good, identically the Philadelphia Eagles. With Kyle Sturgis's attempt at extra point, which was missed.
#HarritonQuidditch. Let us know who you're rooting for. I don't know how I got. In this 2015 final game. Once again, this is the Harriton 2015 Quidditch.
Yes, 2015,
not 2014. And we have Hufflepuff Yellow playing Gryffindor Red. It's like an intense battle that will be scored as of right now. But that will surely change very shortly. As prior papers I mentioned, No snitches have been taken yet.
Snitches.
That's what I said.
Can we get a what for Gryffindor?
Can we get a what for
Hufflepuff?
Alright, yeah. Just ignore Ricky. Anywho, this should be a pretty intense battle.
There's 15 minutes left in regulation.
I'm sure we'll see a post in the herd about this tonight.
Oh yeah, this is truly intense.
Bruh. Whoa. Moving down the field. What's going to happen? A pass to the
No good. No good.
Unfortunately, fortunately, I don't know. What happens. No good. No good on that Gryffindor shot. Gryffindor heading back in. Let's see what happens. Whoa, Gryffindor. Raven. Whoa, Hufflepuff steals the ball. Steals the...
The quaffle.
Oh. Question is, can Hufflepuff keep it?
This game is just really incredible. I love watching these quaffles just flying around everywhere.
There's only one quaffle.
By the way, if you haven't been told, we have our very own J.K. Rowling is at the Snack Shack right now signing autographs on your hand in the Harry Potter books if you happen to be carrying one.
I hear Hermione is over in the Black Box Theater.
Emma Watson? Wow.
No, I mean Hermione.
That is even more spectacular.
Over in the Black Box. But don't go over there.
By the way, you're all muggles. So yeah. Muggle. You all muggles.
Can we get a what for the muggles?
Y'all muggles.
Yeah.
Currently the yellow Hufflepuff wizards. Never mind. Score as of right now is 10. Never mind. Who's zero? What an intense game tonight.
Gryffindor.
Looks like ball re-emerging into the field. Currently, Gryffindor in possession. What's going to happen?
Gryffindor passes it over to another person in the Gryffindor field. The Gryffindor person is holding it back, throwing it over.
Whoa, what an interception by Hufflepuff.
But then a bludger is hurt, and then he's thrown in, and it is...
No good on that Hufflepuff throwing with the quaffle after an interception. I'll be passing it over to another anchor, but I will be interjecting very frequently.
I also will be.
Yes, we know.
Hashtag SynchroChat.
So now, as we continue on to the game, Gryffindor, the keeper, now with the quaffle. And it will be a...
Whoa, look at that. Gryffindor running with the quaffle. Gryffindor. What's going to happen?
So now, Gryffindor leading across the middle of the
field. Oh, wait, there's a snitch! There is a snitch on the far side of the field! Look to the right! Can the Hufflepuff get it? Or will it be Gryffindor? I cannot tell! Oh my gosh!
And it looks like it's Gryffindor!
Gryffindor has gotten the snitch as we
Whoa,
are
taking Hufflepuff with the quaffle, and Hufflepuff passes, and what's gonna happen? Oh, what a block it by Gryffindor. Red Gryffindor blocks a quaffle.
So now Gryffindor.
Oh, what looks like Gryffindor? Now in position. What's gonna happen?
No good.
Block by yellow Hufflepuff.
So, as I now pick up this heavy microphone, we see the snitch. Oh, no, that's not the snitch. Is that the snitch? Nope, that is the quaffle. That is the quaffle now rolling back onto the field. Picking up by Hufflepuff, walking, running, and running through the goal post thingy, the bobbins. And Hufflepuff now taking it past the 40, past midfield, past the other 40-yard line, past the 30, drawing
in striking distance.
And it is...
It's good!
Good! Hufflepuff scores!
10 Hufflepuff points for yellow. 10 points for yellow. Repeat.
It's a tie game, so it's all even up. It's basically a new game, as they would say.
It's all tied up?
Oh, it isn't tied up. Nope. I don't know.
Another horrible reporting job by Ricky. Anywho, for your non-Harry Potter intense mega fans, it is Quaffle. Not waffle. The more you know.
But don't you want a waffle now after talking about quaffles but for so long?
You know,
head on
I
over
think
to
I
the
do.
Snack Shack for some Belgian waffles.
I think it's time we start selling waffles in the form of a ball, and we'll call that Waffle Quaffle. Yes.
Well, we've had better names, but sure.
We'll make actual quaffles out of waffles.
Now coming in on 10 minutes left in the Harriton 2015 Quidditch Finals here at the Harriton Stadium in Rosemont, Pennsylvania. For those of you just coming in right now, we have yellow Hufflepuff, red Gryffindor.
Go Hufflepuff, go Gryffindor.
The question is, Ricky, do you think Gryffindor can retain that title after their intense victory last year?
I'm really not sure. This game is so incredibly close to now. I don't know who to pick. I came in here not favoring anyone. I'm still not favoring anyone, as this game is just too close, as these teams are just too superb as a group. This is just going to be such a close game as we all intently watch the game go on. And it looks like Hufflepuff is excited. Hufflepuff got the snitches, we are told. Or did they? Okay. We must continue talking, as that is our job, so I will just continue talking.
Oh, say.
Hold on a second. Give me this. Stop. Is the scoreboard correct right now for the people? Know the score. All right.
So there was no snitch.
Was that
in the lead?
Our referee's listening. Is the scoreboard right. correct right now?
We have confirmation that the scoreboard is indeed.
Wait, look.
The scoreboard is indeed correct. Hufflepuff.
No.
Sorry. I take that back.
It is not correct. They're telling us something.
Scoreboard is being changed right now.
We don't know what's going on.
Yeah, Ricky, just don't get run down there. We have our very own Ricky Sayer checking in on the score right now.
I'm not checking in on the score.
If you know what the correct score is, please head on over to the press booth, and we'd be happy to change the score.
Yeah, we have no sounds anymore. What? Fine, you brought the score up, man. You brought the score up. I wasn't talking about it.
Looks like Gryffindor with the quaffle, Gryffindor, will they make this shot? Will they make it?
No.
No good, unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on who you're rooting for Gryffindor. Red Gryffindor.
I'm not saying anything. I didn't bring up the sport.
Stop, you can't rip.
Now it seems that the referees are giving Gryffindor the quaffle. Gryffindor going back to the side.
Yes, there is action. Action is returned.
Gryffindor
with a long throw. Is it good? No good. No good. As they give us some type of motion.
And
Hufflepuff bringing it back. Hufflepuff throwing it down the field.
Quidditch, that is. Hufflepuff about to get it and knocks it away, avoiding the bludger narrowly, and it'll be a pass over towards the middle of the pitch. And now within striking distance is Hufflepuff, but hit with the bludger is Hufflepuff, so it will now be Gryffindor quaffle. Gryffindor now going along with the quaffle. And it'll be a long pass down towards the middle of the pitch. Gryffindor now running down, looking for an opening. It's a close game. It's anyone's game with just under 6 minutes left in regulation.
Nobody cares. I wasn't standing. He's the manager. That's what you're saying, okay? He's the poison. He's the athletic assistant. He works with Mr. Fur.
this one. He gets the zero, we're done, right?
So, Gryffindor now with the quaffle. A pass out towards the middle of, out towards the striking distance. And now it looks like Hufflepuff with the quaffle. Oh, and look at this, the Golden Snitch is out.
The Golden Snitch is out. Where is the Golden Snitch?
Alright, this is it, ladies and gentlemen. We're approaching the final 5 minutes.
5 minutes right now.
When that clock hits zero, Harriton history will be made.
Literally, third annual Quidditch competition.
And look at this. They got the snitch. Extending the lead to 60 to 20.
Who's winning? Griffin?
I'm not talking about score, I thought.
Who's winning? Griffin?
Hufflepuff, we definitely do know Hufflepuff is winning. Hufflepuff been playing very, very good here in this game. Hufflepuff very, very excited. But you know what? There are still snitches to be out there, and the snitches could be caught by the Gryffindors of the doors, and the Gryffindors could come back. I think they could very easily come back in this game.
Let me take a mic for a little
bit. No, and the Gryffindors could easily come back. And there's a kerfuffle on the far side of the field, as there's a kerfuffle here in the booth. The kerfuffling is the kerfuffles. And the ball is being run down the field by Gryffindor. Gryffindor passes. Gryffindor is running, throwing over. Gryffindor is getting, and it is good. Good for Gryffindor. That's another 10 points for Gryffindor. That'll make the, Gryffindor is coming back.
The question is, can Gryffindor retain their title after the resounding victory last year?
Let's move this over. Nice. And look at this, the Golden Snitch is now out on the pitch.
Oh yes, the Golden Snitch
golden
is there.
Snitch is
the Golden
there.
Snitch is speaking. And can Gryffindor get it? The Gryffindor has gotten the Golden Snitch.
And that'll be
like
an extra 20. It looks like that'll be an extra 20 points. For
Golden.
20 points for.
They are quickly
Gryffindor.
Coming back. The
Red.
Score. The score on the according to the scoreboard is 50 to 60. Won't say anything more about that.
So now it is within striking distance for Gryffindor. It's anyone's game now with just under 3 minutes left in regulation.
Oh.
With 2.5 minutes left, questions are now raised and made as to whether Gryffindor Red can retain their title from last year when they had a resounding victory.
Sports, you know, is a great thing. Anything can happen in sports.
Whoa,
look at
looks
Gryffindor.
Like Red, Gryffindor running with the quaffle. And they dropped the quaffle. Taken by Yellow Hufflepuff.
Some slowing in the action right now. As I was saying, sports is incredible.
And intercepted by Gryffindor. Gryffindor now going a long pass across the pitch. And now Gryffindor leading in striking distance. And that will be knocked away by Hufflepuff. Hufflepuff now going to get the quaffle.
If there's a time to be watching intensely, it is now as we close in on 1.5 minutes left.
The 2 minute warning now coming up. Yes.
In the 2015 Harriton Quidditch Finals. Once again, for those of you just tuning in or just starting to watch for real, then we have Red Gryffindor, Yellow Hufflepuff. Yellow Hufflepuff currently in the lead. Closing in on 1.5 minutes, that is 90 seconds, ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who did not take arithmetic in elementary school.
So now.
This is getting more intense by the second. More intense by the second.
It's good. Who's it good for?
It's
that's
good.
Gryffindor.
Good
the score
Gryffindor.
Is tied. The score
Gryffindor
is tied.
Ladies
the score
gentlemen.
Is tied. With 1:19 left, the score is tied.
And ladies and gentlemen, we're closing in on 70 seconds left in the game.
Oh, no, but a man is down. A man is down.
Stop. Ladies and gentlemen, please, moment of silence.
No.
They're stopping the clock. They should be stopping the clock.
The clock has been stopped as there's someone down to the field. I'm now looking into the binoculars to see what's going on.
Okay. And all of Gryffindor.
Currently 62 seconds left on the clock. It looks like there is a...
I don't know. Give me this.
It looks like we have a
Gryffindor
player down.
Gryffindor player down on the field. He is getting up. He's walking.
Time reset to 90 seconds.
He is walking up the field. He's walking on his own. So everyone can we have a clap for the injured Gryffindor player. a clap for the injured Gryffindor player, everyone. As the time is reset to 1 minute 30 seconds left on the clock. We're taking this is our gonna be our final break because this is so close. It is tied game. 1 minute 30 seconds left.
90 seconds to determine the fate of the 2015 Harriton Quidditch Cup.
It is the Harriton cooking class crunch time for both schools.
So
thank you, Ricky, for that incomprehensible joke. Anywho, 90 seconds left.
Oh, it is so exciting.
Seconds.
Holy, ready. Stop
that. 60 all. That is 60 for Gryffindor Red.
I am
60
jumping.
For Hufflepuff Yellow.
I am jumping up and down for how excited I am.
Ricky is literally jumping in the booth for excitement. That would be him. Now, here
please
is where...
Please see recording of him jumping at the ramp report.
Stop.
Oh,
so
it's
now,
so exciting.
Now,
whoa.
We are in a situation of Gryffindor and Hufflepuff tied 60 all with a minute and 30 left in the finals.
Now, last year there was a tie, I believe, at the end of the last game. So here's what happened last year. The games were slightly longer last year, so they actually played after the lights had started to be turned off. Now, I don't expect that to happen today because games are only 20 minutes long now, so if there is a tie at the end of the game, we could be actually seeing overtime.
And I think that in this last 90 seconds, I believe that a golden snitch could be a game changer here. That would add 20 points to either side, and it would be detrimental to have to come back from such a deficit with so little time left. So now, both teams getting ready to start again. So now,
yes, they did.
The referee is resetting.
We have reports that if there is the contingency of a tie,
don't say that.
Currently unconfirmed reports. Forget about it. Never mind. I'm not going to talk about that. Anywho, 90 seconds left in the clock. Game has not yet restarted. We're talking about a tied game for those of you who have been totally ignoring every single thing we've been saying. 60 all, 60-60. To reiterate, 60 for Gryffindor Red and 60 for Hufflepuff Yellow.
And it looks like the game is about to have the restart. It's about to happen. This is the equivalent of a NASCAR. This is the equivalent of a NASCAR when there is two laps left and they go into a caution. This is the equivalent of them coming out of that caution.
Hold on a second. It looks like the referees are getting our attention.
Please clarify.
As they are figuring out this situation, we think that we should recap the game so far. In game one, Gryffindor won 90-80, just a narrow lead over Ravenclaw.
It was
in
so very narrow.
In game two, we saw a Hufflepuff victory over Slytherin by a score of 80-40. And now, right now, in the finals, we have the winners, Hufflepuff against Gryffindor, and they are currently tied 60-60 with a minute 30 left.
Don't forget.
And now the game is restarted, so start the play clock.
Don't forget to check out the snack shack before you leave today to get some really good food.
Yes, a very special for
okay,
whatever.
Okay, and now we're reacting as this is getting so exciting as Hufflepuff is now quickly moving down the field. Oh my gosh! Oh my, and he pushes it in, but it doesn't look like it goes in as it is intercepted by Ravenclaw.
I'm sorry, I intercepted by Gryffindor, to clarify. Gryffindor is red.
Gryffindor, leading all the way down the pitch.
Closing
Gryffindor.
In on 60 seconds left on the clock as this game gets more intense by the millisecond. 60 seconds flat, 60-60. Who will win the game? Will it be Hufflepuff? Yellow. Gryffindor, red.
So now we have Hufflepuff leading down in striking distance.
Oh!
No good.
Did he go in? No, did not.
No good.
No good
rules. Jake Diamond Ravitch, the referee.
We're approaching 37 seconds left. No one is taking a lead.
Closing in on 30 seconds. This raises questions as to what will happen when that clock ticks zero.
Oh, it's so incredibly exciting as the clock is running down.
24 seconds. This is happening live here at Harriton Stadium in Rosemont, Pennsylvania.
Live. This is in Rosemont, Pennsylvania, because we are watching this.
To clarify, we're not in China. We are at the stadium with you guys right now. Closing in on 10 seconds. Gryffindor takes the quaffle. What will happen?
Oh my god.
Gryffindor runs down the field. Closing in on 7,
oh
5
god.
Seconds.
Oh my god.
What is the
play? 3, 2,
One!
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a tied game! What will happen? Referees Noah Carpel and Jake Diamond Ravage will be ruling shortly. Please stay with us as we update you
on this new information. Events.
Thank you.
So let's see what Mr. Robinson says. We don't know what's going to happen here.
They're now ruling.
You don't know what's going to happen?
This is not an unheard of contingency. Last year, in the resounding victory for Gryffindor, there was.
Last year, the finals also ended.
And that was in the dark.
So now, and last year, there was controversy over how the overtime or sudden death should be played. So this year, hopefully, the refs are all
come to an appropriate compromise.
I don't expect this to be a normal overtime period. I expect there to be a sudden death for a certain amount of time. After that certain amount of time is over, they will have to go to penalty shots or whatever you call that in Quidditch. We just certainly do not have the time here at Harriton Stadium to play on until 1 a.m. like they did in baseball during Game 1 of the World Series.
Is that what happened?
Yes.
Whoa.
Now, these are, of course, unconfirmed reports, so don't quote us. Looks like there are currently meetings ongoing on the field for yellow Hufflepuff, Gryffindor red. For those of you who have been totally 100% just not at all paying attention to anything going on right now, we have a tied game. A game just ended. Not sure what to do in this type of contingency. We have 60 Gryffindor red. 60.
This is so incredibly exciting. So incredibly exciting.
Ricky has actually left the booth in excitement. He is so excited. I cannot describe it to you.
Talk louder.
Looks like we are having a ruling coming out very shortly. Please stick with us.
Oh!
Wait.
Oh!
Wait. What is happening
here? A ruling has been made!
Wait, what? I don't know what's going on.
Well, let's stop talking. Let's stop talking until we figure out what it is.
Oh my gosh!
Ricky's doing jumping jacks. What's going on? You know that this is an intense game when Ricky just randomly starts doing jumping jacks.
And Hufflepuff is trying to get the crowd.
Hufflepuff, trying to rile up the crowd.
Oh yeah, get here. Let's get excited, everybody!
Yeah, break that moves, yeah, boy.
Patrick Stewart of the Hufflepuff team is getting the crowd excited. Oh yeah,
Hufflepuff, if you can hear me, you are definitely getting
Gryffindor
really excited.
Gryffindor, however, is also getting pretty hype out there.
Why are they talking to my camera? Who is holding my camera right now? I do not know. No, seriously. Who is controlling my camera right now? I don't think that's Bryce. I honestly have no clues on my camera right now.
Where is that Ian?
I'm kind of worried, actually. I honestly don't know who's on my camera. Should I be worried?
No.
You have Ricky's camera. Please call 1-800.
Ricky's camera. We have a good time here. A lot of banging going on
here. I'm only expected very shortly.
There's only a few people on the field now. They have gone down to like three people on, or three people on either team.
A sudden death with fewer players. It looks to be about 3-on-3.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have unconfirmed reports that the determining factor in the victory tonight will be a sudden death game.
Get hype, everyone. Get hype.
United States of America.
So much football, Harden football. I think I would know by now. Harden, is it? It's good! Is it? No. I don't know.
Breaking news, we have a Get out of here!
Oh, so now Gryffindor takes it down the field. Gryffindor, oh my gosh! Oh my god! Gryffindor, can they do it? The pass is up. Oh, but intercepted by Hufflepuff. Hufflepuff now running down back down the field. Oh,
40. Down, down, down to the 45. Pass midfield. Bam, bam, bam. Bam, bam, bam. Okay, we will talk not as loud now. So now, slowness happening on the pitch.
The pitch? What pitch, Ricky?
Gryffindor pushes Hufflepuff back.
The music.
We actually played this last year.
So now.
For what?
We used to band in the church.
Oh my god.
Oh, it was really nice.
Oh.
We played it really well.
And it appears that Gryffindor has. Yes! Goal!
Oh my god!
Gryffindor wins the third round of 2015
at the
Quidditch competition. They are celebrating on the field. This is an exciting time for sports here at Harriton as Gryffindor wins it. Wins it again for the second year, or the third second year, at least the second year in a row. This is so exciting. So incredibly a great time for Gryffindor, a great time to take game played by both sides. Here's Hunter Sporn with more.
It looks like the Harry Potter team always prevails, as we've seen not only in the Harriton Potter series of novels and movies,
Harriton
but
Potter
here
series.
At Harriton High School, where sports history has just been made as Gryffindor. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for sticking with us. For more, please check out youtube.com/RickyReports.
I never said that, but you know what? This has been an incredible game. We would like, on behalf of the student council, we thank you for coming out here tonight.
I am Ricky Reports. Thank you.